Hey gamers, it's Artea. For those of you that may not know me, all you really need to know is that I'm a basement YouTuber that makes ESO content that primarily concerns the notion of making gold in ESO. Whether you're a fan of actively seeking out ways to make gold, like going from node to node, or spending more time in the guild trader menu in one day than you've spent outside all week because you're looking to flip items for gold, not that I'm speaking from personal experience or anything, or whether you're more interested in acquiring gold passively, like from running dungeons with friends or clapping cheeks in Cyrodiil, I'd like to think that there's content on my channel for everyone. And throughout this content creation journey of mine that I've been on, I've been asked a lot of questions about making gold on ESO, both in my comments section and on my Discord server. Something that actually happens quite frequently on my server is that someone will ask a question, and then in response, a few of my server regulars will drop some knowledge and say something along the lines of, well, you see, there's this YouTuber named Art Yerbamate or Art Coffee or something like that, who makes these videos that kind of answer your question, or something to that effect, and then they'll drop a bunch of links to my videos that are relevant to the question at hand. It gives me a laugh every time, but it also makes me realize that some of the concepts that I touch on in my videos could be lost in translation. I try to keep my explanations as short and as precise as possible, without being too bland and boring with my presentation style, but I can see how in doing so, I may not fully elaborate enough on certain points that get brought up in my videos, or they get lost behind my stupid editing style. To be fair, I've also been guilty myself of not being as accurate or as clear as I could be, and not because I was negligent, or meaning to be negligent, but because I simply didn't have enough readily available and reliable information to have been able to come to the most accurate conclusion. Fortunately, finding this community of other gold enjoyers has helped me attain so much more reliable knowledge to be able to enrich my videos and be much more accurate with how I apply my knowledge to the set of data that these gamers provide me to come to much more accurate conclusions. I'm very grateful for everyone that shares their findings with us on the server. So I'd like to take the opportunity to kind of speed run through a bunch of the most commonly asked questions that I get about making gold on ESO to hopefully and definitively be able to answer them for you. And so I don't have to answer the same question 10 times a day on the server. I was originally planning on making this one long ass video, but I think it'd be best if I made this a series of bite-sized episodes instead. So I'm sorry for the long introduction, but this series did need a preface. Without further ado, let's get into one of the most commonly asked questions that I get on my Discord server. My most viewed video is one that discusses a few gold farming mistakes. One of those mistakes is opening up all of your daily reward coffers from a specific daily at once, instead of opening them until a motif is attained. Why is this a mistake? Well, because of cooldowns. Let me briefly explain. Daily reward coffers have a chance to drop motifs from their respective zones. It was discovered by the ESO community that daily reward coffers that came after elsewhere started implementing 20-hour cooldowns on the motifs that drop from them. Some speculate that this is a means to force replayability and encourage players to keep doing dailies every day, so as to collect an entire motif style over time, as opposed to getting the whole thing in one day. These cooldowns are account-wide, not character-wide. This means that should I get a motif from a zone that came out after elsewhere, such as the Wayward Guardian motif from the Wayward Guardian dailies in Markarth, I will not be able to get the chance to receive another motif of the same style. Again, in this case, that would be the Wayward Guardian motif. On any character on my entire account for 20 hours. To go along with our example, this does not mean that you're guaranteed a Wayward Guardian motif every 20 hours. It means that a Wayward Guardian motif simply will not even have the chance to drop for you until 20 hours have passed. These cooldowns are also motif specific. If you get a Wayward Guardian motif, you'll still be able to get an Arcsand Armory motif in that 20-hour time period, for example. Yes, those two motif styles are from the same zone, but they're ultimately different motif styles, so they're on different cooldowns. They also come from different dailies. Getting a motif from one will not place you on a cooldown for receiving the other, or any other motif for that matter. A lot of people misunderstood the language that I used in this video. They mistook daily reward coffers for event coffers, when those are not the same thing. Purple event coffers that you get from events do not drop any items on cooldown, so feel free to open those at any time. Style pages, which are gold and say style page on them, are not motifs, which are purple and say crafting motif on them. Style pages like the ones that you can get from opening Undaunted coffers or event boxes do not drop on cooldown. People also mistook motifs for furnishing plans, which are not the same thing, although some furnishing plans do have a chance to drop from certain dailies. Speaking of furnishing plans, those are also believed to have cooldowns. Unlike motifs that come from daily reward coffers, these cooldowns are character-wide, not account-wide. What I mean by this is that once a purple furnishing plan is found by looting a container on one of your characters, that character will be placed on a cooldown and will be unable to have the chance to loot another plan of the same rarity for a set amount of time. People have speculated that to be around a half hour for these purple plans. Players suggest that there are no cooldowns in place for green or blue plans. Mind you, it is difficult to ascertain the truth behind these cooldowns because of the fundamentals of how RNG works. With the large pool of data that we now have in regards to player experiences with looting plans though, we can remove outliers and be a little more confident in this theory. I'll say this, some of the most financially savvy folks in the game will always recommend farming for furnishing plans by parking characters in one place and then rotating through them. As soon as one character picks up a purple furnishing plan, they'll swap to the next character so as not to be hindered by any cooldown when farming for plans. These people claim that this is the most efficient way to farm furnishing plans. You can choose to follow the footsteps of these ESO moguls, or not, that's up to you. I've personally received blue furnishing plans back to back, and I mean back to back, one right after the other, from opening up dragon furnishing plan satchels and furnishing satchels that came from looting the ash pile after defeating a harrow storm. This leads me to believe that blue furnishing plans don't have any cooldown. Either that, or the furnishing plans that come from world events have their own unique set of rules. I've had a fair amount of people try to dispute this claim by saying that they picked up two purple furnishing plans at once. Yeah, that's the homemaker perk coming into play, my guy, and has nothing to do with cooldowns. I've also had some people comment that they picked up purple plans one right after another when looting through a home. When I asked what plans they were, they got back to me and told me that one of them was a furnishing plan and the other was a motif book, which is not the same thing as a furnishing plan. Leads also do not drop on cooldown, so don't worry if you were planning on completing a bunch of treasure maps for potential leads for motifs in a row. Nothing's gonna hinder you from receiving a lead. Trust me, I've received multiple leads for ancestral motifs back to back all the time. I also, one time, completed over 20 maps in Western Skyrim and Blackreach and did not receive a single lead for an ancestral motif. I guess I should have bought some more crowns or something to increase my RNG. Which reminds me, something else that I quickly want to bring up regarding cooldowns. The reason why I want to bring this information about motif and plan cooldowns to light is to help you all be much more efficient when farming gold. I don't want your hard-earned reward coffers, from dailies that came after elsewhere of course, to go to waste, as they would if you just opened all of them up after receiving a motif from them. I also don't want you guys to spend so much time farming for rare furnishing plans when you're already on a cooldown for purple ones, so you won't be able to get another on that tune for a little while. I've seen a lot of talk recently where people wonder if all sorts of items drop on cooldown. Some people wonder if style pages from event coffers indeed drop on cooldown. The same people claim that they've opened up 10 or so event coffers without receiving a single style page. I've also seen people claim that rare materials like ethereal dust or Nurnkrux drop on cooldown because they've been farming nodes for days or weeks without receiving one. Or that even leads are on cooldown because they, like me, have done a bunch of treasure maps and have not received a single ancestral motif lead. I implore that you try your best to not confuse having some bad RNG for an item having a cooldown. Ethereal dust is just a super rare mat, and whether or not it does drop on cooldown, that's irrelevant. That shouldn't discourage you from picking up nodes that are close by, or even farming for nodes using a super efficient route. I'd hate for someone to say that they're not gonna farm nodes anymore on account of something as baseless as this. Items from event coffers having cooldowns would be completely counterintuitive, seeing as the entire point of an ESO event is to encourage players to participate in event tasks, not discourage them. Again, I'd hate for talk like this to discourage players from playing the game. The cooldowns on motifs and plans make sense, as they encourage replayability, but a lot of these other cooldown propositions just aren't reasonable. In my opinion anyways, and God forbid I have one of those on the internet. Anyways, I didn't ever mean to open any kind of Pandora's box here when I made that original video on cooldowns. I simply want to help you guys make the most of your time here on ESO. So next time you hear someone somewhere bring up a cooldowns conspiracy theory, consider how practical such a theory may be. consider if it's just bad RNG, and consider if it should even affect your playstyle or not. Of course, before I made the video that explains cooldowns, and even after the video had long since been published to YouTube, there were, and there likely always will be, those gamers in zone chat pressing X to doubt and screaming into the void that motif cooldowns are a hoax invented by the government to brainwash us or something equally based. But no, actually, people dispute these cooldown theories that concern furnishing plans and motifs from dailies, and honestly, I don't have the energy to argue with these people. Just like the gamers that insist that some items have cooldowns when they really do not, if these people want to be inefficient with their farming strategies, then I say they should go for it. It's better for us enlightened traders because that means it'll keep the supply of these items lower, which means that we can charge more for these items. I entertained this argument in my original video. If you want to listen to me destroy these people with facts and logic, I won't be repeating myself here. If you play on PC, you can even get the add-on Item Cooldown Tracker to help you track cooldowns for items that are known to have them, like these newer motifs that have been coming out, as well as some other things like Arena Gladiator Proofs and Siege of Cyrodiil Merits if you're a PvP enjoyer. Myself and a lot of the gamers over in my Discord server have been employing some efficient farming methods when it comes to farming for plans and motifs, such as opening coffers that reward a certain motif one at a time until we get that motif, and then saving the rest for the next day, so that we have a greater chance at receiving a motif of that style every single day, or swapping tunes when looking for a new and valuable furnishing plan, and this has been working great for us. I hope that this information can be as useful to you guys as it has been for them. If you'd like to join our community, I'll leave links to my Discord server in the description. And if you have any more questions about cooldowns or would like to share your farming experiences, feel free to let us know about them in the comments. Thank you guys for watching, and thank you to all my YouTube members for going the extra mile in supporting my content creation journey. Alright guys, that's all for today. I'll see you guys in the next video. Cheers!
Say what's on my brain, but I wonder.